My research is on corrosion of stainless steels, mainly the steels that silverware and other cutlery are made out of. And I work on corrosion in seawater applications, so primarily for power plant cooling, but also for chemical plants and stuff like that where they have stainless steel tubing. And I look at the mechanical properties that are affected by corrosion. In high school, I took a metallurgy for machinists and welders class at a local community college, and that got me interested in metallurgy in general. So I started working with metal and actually making tools rather than just using them, and I discovered I could actually make things on my own rather than just use things that people had made. I learned techniques in the lab that I can use in my garage, and I learned techniques in my garage that I can use in the lab. So I have a propane forge, which is where I do most of the work. I also have a charcoal forge that I built, and I use that for doing welding because it can get to a higher temperature. I have the standard blacksmith anvil, and that has a whole bunch of different uses. It can hold tools, it can just be for hammering, it can be for shaping. When I have other helpers, we'll use this for sledgehammering metal. So the power hammer is to hammer metal without tiring my arm. I have a furnace, which is used for melting metal for casting. I also smelted copper from ore using it. I've made a pata, which is an Indian sword where you grab it with your fist and it sticks straight out and there's a gauntlet around your arm. I've made a falchion, which is a pretty standard European sword, and what we concentrated on there was making an interesting handle, so we did a twisted wire wrap. I've made a kopesh, which is the original sword ever made. It's an ancient Egyptian bronze sword, and that required melting the bronze. I actually smelted it from copper ore. I would encourage high schoolers and even middle schoolers to look around the world and see what interests you, because even if you don't know what the science is that studies it, there's probably something. I didn't know what material science was until I started college, but I knew that I was interested in materials long before that. So look around the world, find something that's interesting, and just go after that.